Hi students, this is Jyoti Miss, your computer teacher. Here, all of you open your textbooks. We are learning first lesson, evolution of computers from textbook. Okay children, in last class we learned how the computer started its journey. Means first, what the calculating devices in that generation that humans were found, the scientists were found, we learned all that. Like that abacus, Napier, bones, Pascal, punched card, difference, engine, analytic. These are all the calculating devices in those days that the scientists and humans are using. After that, like that the computer journey is developing. Then they found the first generation computers, those are analytical engines. So children, like this, the computer was started their journey and now reach like this shape they formed the computers. Okay, now children, regarding to this development, from starting onwards to till now, the computers, depending upon these developing features, the computer generations are divided into 5 types. Those are called classification of computers. Means depending to this development of computers, the computers are divided into 5 generations. Those are first generation, second generation, third generation, fourth generation, fifth generation. Now we will discuss briefly what's about that. About the first generation, we learned in last class. So what is the first generation? First generation computer era was it's run on 1940 to 1958. First generation era is going. Went on 1940 to 1958. These time of period we call as first generation computers. Means in those days, those are using 1G computers, 1G speed, 1G data speed computers they are using. In those computers, they used vacuum tubes to make the computer work. Understand, children? So we already learned what are the disadvantages of first generation computers. In vacuum tubes, those are in big size and it is a very costly item to use in computers. And these first generation computers takes more space it occupies. To keep a computer, it occupies more space. If you keep this computer, we want a room, a big room, we want to keep this computer, and working with this computer is also very hard. Okay, so about this we learned in last class. Next, coming to second generation computers. Second generation computers, these era went on 1959 to 1964. In this time of period, they found 2G computers. They are using 2G computers. In those days, humans are using 2G computers. In those computers, they used transistors. They used transistors in the place of vacuum tubes to make the computer works. Okay, children. So today we will discuss about what are the second generation computers and how it will work, and the remaining all we will learn now. So children, open your page number 9. See the bottom of the page. Second generation computers. 1959 to 1964. This era we called as the second generation computers era. Means in this time of period, they are using 2G computers. So the second generation computers had the following features. So what are the features of second generation computers? And what are the advantages? What are the disadvantages? We will see. These computers used transistors in their circuits, which provide very fast and efficient. They were smaller, faster, cheaper, and more efficient than the first generation computers. They included all the components, printer, storage capacity, disk storage, operating system, etc. The programming languages like COBOL and Fortran came into use. IBM 1401 and RCA 501 are some examples of second generation computers. So see children, these in the place of vacuum tubes. In first generation computers, we are using vacuum tubes. that days. But in the second generation computers, they used transistors. They used transistors in their circuits to make the computer work. So these transistors are very fast working and it's very cheap and very efficient. Okay, compared to first generation computers, second generation computers works fast than the first generation computers. And in these computers, we can use printers and it have storage capacity, disk storage and operating system, that all features these second generation computers are supporting. In first generation computers, these are all not supporting. These all features are first generation computers are not supporting. But in second generation computer, these are all features. Means we can print, we can use printer in 2G computers. And it has storage capacity also. We can store data and disk storage is also there. And operating systems also in this computer we can use. In first generation computer, those are all only simply we can calculate. This is simply calculation device. But here, calculating device and storage device and these all we can use in the second generation computer. And in this second generation computers, we are using languages also. Which languages means it supports COBOL, Fortran, like these languages we are using and we are giving instructions and we are writing small programs by using 2G computers. Okay, in IBM 1401, RCA 501, the best examples of the 2G computers. Okay children, this is about the 2G computers, means second generation computers. Next, coming to the third generation computers. Third generation computers means this time of period 1964 to 1970. In this time of period, the computers were little bit developed and updated their features and it became as a 3G computer and became as a 3G computers. 1964 to 1970, they are using, then that humans are using this 3G computers. In this 3G computers, in the place of vacuum tubes and in the place of transistors, they are using integrated circuits and ICs. We call these are ICs, IC chips. Okay. So what are these? We will see. See page number 10, third generation computer, 1964 to 1970. Here given now, these are IC chips. Okay. So see, the third generation computers had the following features. They used integrated circuits, ICs, also called chips. They were small in terms of size, especially if you compare them with second generation computers. They had greatly enhanced storage capacities than the second generation computers. They are used as operating systems that allowed them to run different programs at the same time. Some examples of third generation computers are IBM 360 series and the 370 series. So children, in third generation computers, in the place of transistors, in second generation computers we are using transistors, no. In that place we are using integrated circuits. These are very very small than compared to the transistor. Okay, and these we called as the ICs or IC chips. Okay children, next you see. Here, what the feature was developed from the first, second generation computer to third generation computer is, here we can store more data. We can, the storage capacity of the computers will be increased than the transistor 2G computers or transistor related computers or 2G computers. If we compare third generation computers, storage capacity will be increased, okay, enhanced. Okay, next, in this they are used as operating system that allowed them to run different programs at the same time. And what is this? Another feature of these 3G computers are, we can run at a time number of programs. We can run at a time number of programs. But in second generation computer, there is no feature like that, no feature. We can run only one program one time. But here in 3G computers, we can run multiple programs at the same time. Like that, we can use a number of windows. And what are the examples of these third generation computers are IBM 360, one of the computer, and then IBM 370 series. These two series are 3G computer, 3G computers, means related to 3G computer generations. Okay. Next, coming to here, what are the fourth generation computers? Fourth generation computers. Now, at present, we are using which computers? 4G computers. That all of you know. So, 1971 to at present time, we are using these fourth generation computers. Now, we are using all computers. Those are 4G computers. That is fourth generation computers. 4G computers means the speed and the capacity of the MB per second is 4G. Okay. See. What is about the fourth generation computers, see children, page number 10. The characteristics of the fourth generation computers are as follows. These computers use microprocessors. They perform the bulk processing and control all parts of system. The use of microprocessor resulted in decreased size and increased efficiency. So children, coming to microprocessor, in the place of ICs, third generation computers we are using ICs, no? But in the place of ICs, in fourth generation computers we are using microprocessor chips. What is the best advantage of these microprocessor chip is the bulk processing and control all parts of the system. This microprocessor chip is very small compared to the ICs, and we can store large amount of data, and it control all parts of the system. Okay, and means it can control unit, logical unit, printer, scanner, and these all very efficiently it will control and make the computer to works very efficiently. Okay children, and that's only. What is the microprocessor? Another advantage is a decreased size of the computer and increased the efficiency, means efficiency of the computer, means working efficiency of the computer increased this microprocessor. Next, see, these computers have much greater computing power and storage capacity than the earlier generation computers. That all of you know. It increased the computing power, means features, working capacity, working with multiple programs at a time, and supporting all types of softwares. These all features are very, very developed, and computing power is developed in the fourth generation computers, and storage capacity also very, very increased comparing to that remaining all third, second, first generations. Next, they use improved storage devices that they are cheaper than the earlier ones. They can be networked together to share storage capacity, space, dates, etc. The examples of fourth generation computers are Apple Macintosh and IBM PCs. So children, so the storage capacity increased, that all space increased, all means storage capacity increased. Space of the computers means we can store more data, and it supports the best feature is it supports networking, means we can connect to any other computers easily, very easily. By pressing one button, we can connect our device to the world by using internet, no? So like this, so many better features are there in these 4G computers. Nowadays we are using, no? The best examples of 4G computers are Apple Macintosh and IBM personal computers. Children, see page number 11. Nowadays, laptops and tablets which can be carried anywhere with ease have become very common. Till the fourth generation computers, the major focus was on reducing size and improving efficiency. This resulted in smaller yet faster computers. The only drawback of these computers is the lack of ability to think which one is attempting to achieve in this so-called fifth generation computers. So children, these are all the advantages of the fourth generation computers. So by this reducing size and increasing efficiency, we found or we invented these laptops, tablets, and now we are using mobile phones. These all are we can carry anywhere with us. Means we are carrying so much of data. We are carrying our world. Our world by using these small computers with us anywhere. So that is the best advantage of this fourth generation computers. Okay, children. So here, what is this fourth generation computers? The major focus was reducing size, increasing efficiency. That only focused scientists in this fourth generation computer. Children, if you compare those remaining three generation, fourth generation is the best generation computer. But in this fourth generation also, another one disadvantage is there. What is that if you think? That is the only drawback, lack of ability to think. Means these fourth generation computers should not think like that humans and should not take decisions like that humans. That is the drawback. The researchers, they are thinking like that. The fourth generation computers as the one of the drawback is lack of the thinking like human beings. To rectify this drawback also, they are going to research and they found the five generation computers at present not, it will come in future. At present in developed countries, they already in working these 5G computers, but till now we did not reach this 5 generation computer. So but in future we will reach this 5th generation computers. In this 5th generation computers, what is the special feature is we are giving artificial intelligence to the computers. We are giving artificial intelligence to the computers, means these 5G computers can take their own decisions. And they also think regarding to the situation. Regarding to the situation, in this situation, what decision we will take? How we will react? Like that, they will think the computers. Like that, the intelligence, nothing but of artificial intelligence, we are giving to the computer in the form of softwares. Okay, so these 5th generation computers, now they are researching and the scientists are going to develop these 5th generation computers in a cheap cost, means in a low cost. They are developing these 5th generation computers to provide to all human beings in a low cost. So that is the 5th generation computer. See what are the best features of 5th generation computers. See page number 11, children. 5th generation computers. The computers of this generation use artificial intelligence. These are 5 categories of artificial intelligence. Means children, these artificial intelligence computers are mainly divided into 5 categories. What are those? See, first, game playing. Computers are programmed to play games such as chess and checkers. So you all of you know, now number of thousands of games are there. They can take their own decision. If you are playing game, they can take their own decision by giving instructions by you. Okay, children, like this game playing means nothing but of these are, this is also first generation computer feature. Next, expert systems. Computers are programmed to make decisions in real life situations. For example, computers help doctors to diagnose diseases based on symptoms. So children, in this 5th generation now doctors, they are diagnosing us, means they are testing us which disease they are having and how the organs are working. Means those are all just they are scanning. After scanning, the decision will take, the report will is giving the computers. Means lungs are some infected, our lungs are becoming small, or like that in full information. What is the report? The computers only giving, means they are taking their own decisions. Are you understanding how they are taking own decisions? We are giving instructions, we are programming them how to take decision in particular situation. If this particular situation will come, how you have to take decision and how you have to give report. So next see the third point, that is natural language. Computers are programmed to understand natural human languages. Means children, computers are programming, these 5G computers are programming, means giving like that type of software. It can understand the human language, means which language we are speaking. If we speak in Telugu, it can understand. If we speak in Hindi, it can understand and give reply. If you speak in English, it can understand, it can give reply. Like that softwares they are installing in these 5th generation computers. So, and what is the next feature is natural networks. Computers are programmed to work with human brain and human nervous system. Means children, how in our body the nervous system is connected to our brain, and how the brain is taking decisions and how the brain is thinking, like that, that type of natural networks software they are installing in 5G computers. Regarding to that 5G, due to this natural networks software, the computer can think by its own and it can take its decisions. So this type of nervous system brain, like this, related to this type of software, they are installing in 5G computers in the form of natural networks. So these all are the features they are implementing in 5G, implementing not already implemented in 5G computers. Next is robotics. Computers are programmed to see, hear and react to sensory stimuli. Children, if you observe in before 1 year or last 6 months, we are listening one. Recently we are listening one word, that is Sophia one, woman android, woman female android, means nothing but a Sophia. It is seeming like a woman, but she is not a woman, it's a computer. And what the special feature, if you see Robo movie, how that same Robo that Rajinikanth is there, how that same Robo, how he is talking, how he is recognizing all senses, how he is giving reply, how the, he is driving car, that all related software installed in that Robo. That's why he is doing all that. Like this in the Sophia also, these all features are installed, means like that this is so, she is giving reply, nothing but of this Sophia is a computer, it's a robot. She is giving reply and she is understanding what we are speaking, and she is giving answers related to which question we are giving. Means she is thinking, she is understanding what language we are speaking, and she is thinking and she is giving a response. She is feeling all. So like this, 5th generation computers are developed nothing but of they are placing these computers in the place of humans. It's nothing but of like how human was created, how the human was working, how the human is working, how the humans are working, like that only these computers also can work more than efficiently compared to the humans. Means some works humans not done more efficiently than the computer. Means computers can do calculations within seconds, and how much number of calculations the computers can do within seconds, but the human he cannot do. Coming to, it can store large amount of data permanently, but human in 1 year, 2 years we can remember the points, and means we can store data, after that we can forgot. So children, so 5G computers are nothing but of they are replacing the humans. nothing but in the place of humans, the Android, these 5G computers are coming. Understanding? So these are all the 5G computers. Okay, children, these are all the features of the 5G computers. In future days, we cannot surprise to see all this, how the humans are working, same the computers are working. In future generation, we are getting confusion, or we are getting, we cannot remember who is a human and what is computer in future generation also. That problem, that big problem also we can face in the future, I think. These type of fifth generation computers, if it were developed. Okay, children. Next, these are all the journey of the computers from first generation to fifth generation. Till now, what computers we are using with the highly featured advanced computers now we are using, that computers was first started their journey like that. First Abacus, a computing calculating device, first that was founded as a calculating device. After that device reached now in the form of fifth generation computers, very highly talented machines in the world. Means some features greater than humans. In some words, they are greater than humans also. They are replacing humans in future. So this is about the journey of the computers. Okay, children. Now see the next topic, characteristics of computers. So how these computers become this much highly efficient machine in the world? In this world, not there any other machine is there more efficient than the computer. How it become? Why we are saying this much efficient, these computers? How it become this much efficient means they are having mainly five characteristics. During these five characteristics, regarding to these five characteristics, the computer become very powerful machine in the world. What are those five characteristics? Now we will discuss. Okay, children, see. Characteristics of computers. A typical modern day computer has the following characteristics. The first one is speed. Computers have very high speed nowadays. They are experts in multitasking and parallel processing jobs. They can run big machines too. Speed of a computer is measured in terms of milliseconds and microseconds or nanoseconds. See children, milliseconds means 10 power minus 3 seconds. Microseconds means 10 power minus 6 seconds. And nanoseconds means 9 power 9 seconds. Okay children? Next, see children, storage capacity. A computer has huge storage capacity. They can store large amount of data. It can store documents, newspapers, books, etc. in its memory, which can be used in future. A human being, on the other hand, can store only limited information in his future. So this is also big advantage and big characteristic or a good feature of the computer, storage capacity. We can store large amount of data, means that maybe newspapers, important documents, books, famous books, important books, documents, songs, movies, what not. We have how much data? If you give that memory card in the computer or in the mobile, we can store large amount of data. Means compared to human, it's having more storage capacity permanently. But if you take a human, a man or a human being, we can store limited information for a short time. After 1 or 2 years, we can forget that all. But computers should not forget. This is the another better feature of the computer. That is characteristic. Next, reliability. Computers are more reliable than human beings as they do not get bored of the repetitive tasks. They never get tired either. Means reliability. How many times you give same task? Computer should not get bored and should not get tired. But if a human can do same task repeatedly, they can get bored. And a human can work 6 hours or 8 hours. After that, they can feel tired. But computers should not get tired. How much time? 24 hours it works. But then also, computer should not tired and should not get bored. That is the reliability, another characteristic of the computer. Next is versatility. A computer can perform various types of jobs. It can type text, draw pictures, play movies and music, do complex calculations and show information. Versatility means various types of tasks, different types of tasks. I already gave an example. For example, if any one machine is there, that one machine do only one particular task. If a bike is there, just we can travel on that bike. Okay. And if you take a TV is there, just we can watch that TV. It's enough. But if you take a computer, it can do all types of works, what not. All types of works. Maximum this world is going on this computer only nowadays. In this corona time, this COVID time, all world is going on this computer. Means they are doing all their works on by using this computer only. Okay, children. So that is the reliability. It can do different types of works. Okay. Coming to our small example, we can type text, draw pictures, play movies, listen music, different big complex calculations also we can do. Okay, children. But these are all small tasks. In the world, the computer is ruling the world nowadays. Is it right? Next, reduction in manpower. Next, what is that? Reduction in manpower. Earlier, every work in industries, factories was done by humans. In olden days, in factories, they are working humans. With the use of computers, any work can be completed by only a few persons and the two with greater accuracy and efficiency. But nowadays, you know, big factories and big companies, industries, in danger zones, some danger areas are there. There also humans should work. That type of situations, in that type of places, nowadays they are using computers. So, nowadays, these computers are replacing humans for doing some different types of works, okay? But these computers can work with more accuracy and efficiency comparing to the humans. So, that's why nowadays, reduction in manpower is reducing manpower and they are increasing the computers, robots, okay, technology, robots, they are using in the place of manpower. They are reducing manpower and increasing these computers. So, these are all the main characteristics of the computer. It makes the computer a wonderful and high efficient machine in the world. These characteristics make the computer wonderful. Missions. Okay, children, these are all about the characteristics of the computer. So, children, this is about the evolution of computer. How the computer started its journey and how it reached till now with these efficient and great features and how nowadays we are using these computers and what are the characteristics of computers. And how the computer generations are divided. Means this computer journey is divided into 5 generations. What are those generations? What are the characteristics of computers? Those are all we learned in this first lesson. What we learned? the starting the machine of the computer, after the generations of the computer, after the characteristics of the computer, we learned in this class. Okay, children. So this lesson explanation is finished. Notes of this lesson I will give in next class. Okay, children. How you have to write notes, what you have to write in the notes, that all I will explain in the next video or in the next class. Now I am closing this class. In the next, we will meet in the next class. Till now, take care. Bye bye. Children, 1 second. What is your homework is, you just revise this full lesson one time. Read this lesson one time, textbook reading, and after that, here see in page number 13, there are multiple choice questions are given and fill in the blanks also given in textbook, page number 13. You write answers for this A session and B session. Means A multiple choice questions and fill in the blanks. You write answers for these two sections. Okay? Write with pencil. In the next class, I will give answers for these all. Then you will check and you will correct. Okay, children? What is your homework is? Fill in the blanks and this multiple choice question and answers in page number 13 by reading the lesson. Okay, homework is read this lesson once and do the exercise in page number 13. Multiple choice question and answers and fill in the blanks. You write with pencil. That is your homework. Okay, children. Okay, I am now closing this class. We will meet in next class. Till then, take care. Bye bye.